Welcome back to LearnOpenCV. In today's video, we'll be diving into slicing aided hyperinference technique and its implementation using a Google Colab notebook.
But before that, let's look into the problem in hand. In the image shown on the screen, a CCTV capture of a traffic scene can be observed. There are tons of vehicles within the image frame. Normal object detectors will not work here as the size of the vehicles are way too small for the detector's receptive field. Here's where SAHI comes in. This specific technique slices the input image into multiple patches and performs sliced inference on the individual patches. In the end, the whole image is reconstructed to show all the small object predictions. Just look at the results we were able to get just by using SAHI. We'll walk you through the code snippets step by step to implement this. So let's get started.
We begin with the first code snippet, which installs the necessary packages required for the SAHI technique. Let's take a look at the code. In this snippet, we use the pip install command to install the required packages. These include Torch, SAHI, YOLO V8, Ultralytics, NumPy, and OpenCV Python. Installing these packages ensures that we have all the necessary dependencies for our SAHI implementation. The runtime needs to be restarted before moving on to the next cell. We can use the next code snippet to check the current working directory. Next, we have a code snippet that imports the YOLO V8 S model and the other functions and classes. Let's dive into the details. In this snippet, we import the download YOLO V8 S model function from the SAHI utils YOLO V8 module. This function enables us to download the YOLO V8 S model, which is essential for our small object detection task. We also import several other utility functions and classes from the SAHI package. These include functions for reading images, downloading files from URLs, getting predictions, visualizing object predictions, and more. Additionally, we import libraries such as NumPy and CV2 for further image processing. In the next code snippet, we first define the path where we want to save the YOLO V8S model. We set it as models/YOLOV8S.pt. Then we use the download YOLO V8S model function to download the YOLO V8S model and save it to the specified path. Next, we download two test images and we put them into a folder called demo data, and these images will be used to demonstrate the SAHI technique. You are also welcome to use your own test images to perform your experimentations. In the next snippet, we use the auto detection model from pre-trained function to initialize the YOLO V8S model. We specify the model type as YOLO V8 and provide the path to the YOLO V8S model file we downloaded earlier. Additionally, we set the confidence threshold to 0.3, which determines the minimum confidence required for a detection to be considered as valid. Finally, we specify the device as CUDA 0 to utilize GPU acceleration if available. In the next snippet, we call the get_prediction function to obtain the object predictions for the image using the initialized YOLO V8S model. The result is stored in the result variable. To visualize the predictions, we use the export_visuals function to export the prediction visualization to the demo_data folder. Then we display the visualization using the image function. In these examples, we can observe that few objects are not getting detected, and these objects are small objects. Let's now move on to the next code snippet that showcases sliced predictions using the YOLO V8S model. In this cell, we call the getSlicedPrediction function to obtain sliced predictions for the given input image. This function slices the image into smaller overlapping patches and predicts objects within each patch. This result variable stores the sliced predictions. We specify parameters such as slice height, slice width, overlap height ratio, and overlap width ratio to control the slicing behavior. These parameters determine the size of each patch and the amount of overlap between patches. And all of these parameters vary from image to image. Finally, let's discuss the last code snippet, which visualizes the object predictions. In this snippet, we load the image using OpenCV and convert it into the RGB color space. Then we convert the image into a NumPy array using the asArray function. Next, we use the visualizeObjectPredictions function to overlay the object predictions on the image. The object prediction list parameter contains the predictions obtained from the sliced prediction. We set hide labels to 1 to hide the object labels. The resulting visualization is saved as result.png in the demo_data folder. And that's a wrap for today's video. Make sure to like and subscribe to our channel for more computer vision content. If you have any questions or suggestions, feel free to leave them in the comments down below. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.